like a good spot. My name is Emily Truman, and this is John Spitalier from Puffer Morris. If you'd like to tell everybody a little bit about yourself.
Well, I've been here since 92-ish, something along that line. I work for a small agency that specializes in city properties.
What is your favorite part about finding someone their dream home?
Favorite part is seeing the happiness on their face when they settle on a house and they start the process of moving in. And, you know, they're just completely happy that they've settled on a place that has character. And it's a joyous thing to be helping people do that.
That is exciting.
I really like that.
That's a big moment in their lives.
Yeah, yeah. Buying a home is one of the biggest moments in your life, next to having kids or anything like that. But to help in that process is really kind of energizing.
Some energizing, like our iced coffee.
Cheers.
Cheers. So, what's the radius that you service around Lancaster?
Well, technically speaking, my area of expertise is the school district of Lancaster, the area Lancaster Township and Lancaster City.
You're a city boy.
I'm a city boy.
What's your ad say again?
Living in the Lank or city boy. City boy was the first one.
Yeah, city
and
boy.
And then it was Mark. And living in the Lank. Well, actually, they were all Mark.
What is the most challenging part of your job?
Well, the market's really hot right now.
Good.
Really, really busy. And that is good. The most challenging part of my job is not working 12-hour days, 14-hour days, 16-hour days. Because I have a tendency to want to help as much as I can and be Johnny on the spot and making time for family is equally as important to me. That work-life balance is pretty important.
So how do you clock out? Like when, at what point in your day do you say, okay, it's time to go home, be with my family?
Well, I work at home. That's helpful. Mm. It's also helpful that Elena is home. It's more of just a question of, I try to take the mornings with her. And then work up until 5 or 6 and then stop and just stop. And then I tell my clients, give me 24 hours to return all your phone calls. It also helps them because they know that there's not everything is in crisis mode. A lot of agents work in crisis mode all the time, and that's why they burn out.
Right.
So I plan to be here for the long haul. So
that's good advice for new real estate agents to sort of balance
chill
it all out.
Yeah,
that's great advice. So you're getting married.
I am. On the
18th. This month, the 18th.
Yeah, I know.
Are you nervous?
No. Not nervous.
Is Elena nervous?
Yes! Elena's nervous!
Aww.
All the planning, the fine details of the last minute stuff is just, the caterer is this, and we gotta pay this bill, and we have to work out the detail. Apparently, the DJ is the most complicated thing in the entire process, because you have to tell the DJ pretty much down to the minute. And to the song, what you're doing for the day. And I said to her last night, she was kind of obsessing about this. I said, I'll write out the rubric for it, and we can just fit in the stuff that needs to be fit. We know 90% of this.
You seem like a good team. True partners.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah.
That's good quality to have. Let's say you were stuck on a desert island. And you actually had the choice to bring 3 items with you. What would they be?
I thought about this one. This is a fun question. I would bring a copy of Sun Also Rises, because it's perhaps one of the greatest pieces of literature ever written. I would bring the pocket knife that my father gave me when I was 12, that the TSA stole from me at the Denver airport because I forgot to put it in my check-on.
Ooh.
I had it since I was 12. It had a little fish scaly thing on it and everything.
But you have it? No, okay,
no,
so it's
gone.
It's
gone.
Aww.
But this is hypothetical, so I would bring that.
It would magically appear.
And see, the third thing, I couldn't call for the third thing. Probably my glasses. Because I'd want to be able to see.
Yeah, absolutely. You want to step
or
on
an extra
it.
Pair of glasses.
That's perfect, yes. Oh my gosh, because if one pair like blew off or you were swimming in the ocean waters to refresh yourself and it went away, that's it.
Done.
You can't see.
Yeah.
You're done.
Well done.
Okay, so what three people would you have with you?
Well, officially, I would have to say my two daughters and Elena.
But,
as the girls probably won't be watching this, I'll just be honest. I take Elena, of course, because, you know, she makes me laugh. And, you should come along.
Sure.
It'd be fun.
I'm down.
You make me laugh, too. And we can correct each other's grammar.
Yes. No, there would be no grammatical corrections for either of us, because it's perfect.
And I think we should bring a complete stranger so we can get to know that person along the way.
That's a good answer. Yeah. I love that answer. That's awesome.
Sure.
Okay, another one. This will be our last question for the day. If you had to eat one food for the rest of your life, every day, what would it be?
Apple pie.
Apple pie?
Apple pie.
A specific kind? Like a specific recipe?
Either my mother's or yours. Because your apple pie is banging.
Thank you. That's so sweet. Did you have that apple?
Did I just say banging?
You did.
I'm sorry. I apologize. I'm really sorry. What? The apple? You made an apple something. It was a mix. One time in your backyard. It was like one of those, it was one of those pies that you like completely slow down and take really, really small bites so you can savor every
bite. Oh yeah, everybody. What was that? I can't remember what kind that was.
I don't remember.
Apple pie.
Yeah.
You like cinnamon?
I do.
Although,
I put garam masala in my apple pies.
Oh, I thought you, wow, okay. So, I thought you did that in pumpkin too.
I do.
Sounds really good.
Yeah, it is really good. Actually, it was Rachel Vianney Reinmiller's idea.
Nice.
Yeah, she wanted me to try it so she didn't have to.
Oh, okay. So if it failed, you could take the blame.
Yeah, then I took the blame.
Right.
But now Rachel gets the credit.
It's beautiful out.
It is a beautiful day. Thank you for doing this.
Of course.
This was fun.
It was nice to see you, sir.
Nice to see you.
All right, thank you.